how much did you guys know about Vampire Academy before signing on to Vampire Academy?
Not much. Personally, for me, I feel like I haven't even heard of the books before I did it. I just really went into it, seeing the sides the way they were and the relationships in between Rose and Lyssa and Christian and Lyssa, and I just kind of did my take on it. And then after that, I realized it was a book series. And so I got the book series, you know, read them, I finished the first book in like 2 days. I was obsessed. And I was like, oh my god, this story of friendship and this vampire world is so incredible. Like, I'm so happy to be part of it.
I was the same way. It was kind of a general audition. And then afterwards, after booking the show, I read the first book and I was like, okay, now I'm a fan. That's great. Now I get to work on this show and be a fan at the same time. So yeah, it was the same thing.
And it was crazy too, because after we booked it, I think we all started really feeling like, oh wait, this is like a thing.
Yeah, like, it's like a real thing.
Like, it was like, oh, you know, it got released that we got cast. I was like, oh yeah, no big deal. And then soon there was like 50 edits of us with like Dragomir this and you know,
Face
us like making
that
out and doing all the shots together. And I was like, oh wow, like these fans like really like love these books. So it just feels like a responsibility and an honor to be like, wow, like we're the ones representing that.
A little bit of a motivation too.
Was there anything really creepy that you're like, no, wait a minute, that's just pushing it too far from the fans?
Oh my god, you know what's so funny? We had this scene one time. I wasn't in it, but I heard of the story and it cracked me up. Jen, who plays Alberta, she's absolutely brilliant. And she had her first scene with the Straboy. The Straboy are like the evil vampires, and our makeup team, which was run by Ana Lozano, amazing as well, they really intricately made them so scary that while we were on set, it was like, okay, action. And she just goes, whoa! She's like, that was quite scary, isn't it? And then we just like started crying, laughing, and she couldn't get through it. Because they were so creepy and scary in person. Oh, they had these like black teeth with the fangs and the red bloodshot eyes, and they're swinging at you too, like as they're trying to kill you in the show. I say the Straboy were like really scary, actually.
Were you talking about the show or the fan art?
Both can work.
But like something creepy of like fan art. Oh my god.
Do you remember? That's what I thought.
No, that was a great story. That was a great story.
You remember that fan that we got that was like deep fakes of our face onto the movie, the Vampire Academy movie? That wasn't creepy, that was so weird to see like our face rendered onto other people. I was like, how do people do that?
So yeah, or like people would, because obviously in the books she's blonde, people would like Photoshop blonde hair on me, but it just didn't suit me. And so I was like, I know y'all want me to be blonde so bad, but like, it doesn't look good.
So, Andre, I know you've been in a number of big franchises, and this is just another one. How intimidating is that, and how intimidating is it for both of you to enter such a big world?
Yeah, I mean, it's an established world, too, which can be pretty scary. I felt the same way with Star Trek as well. It's like, there's a core fan base, there's established rules to this world, and coming in as like a newcomer, it can feel a little bit intimidating, but I'll give full props to not only our cast, but our writing team, Julie and Margaret as well, because they absolutely made us feel so comfortable and so much like we had a place to be here to play, but also to collaborate as well. So whatever nerves I had after meeting those two was just wiped away. And after meeting Daniela, I was like, oh, I'm good.
Same here with meeting him. And yeah, I mean, Julie and Marguerite obviously have done this and they're really great at what they do. So I think having that was like a breath of fresh air, and they definitely had like a whole vision too, so it was just incredible to be along for the ride and see it as well, like as an actor, and be like, oh my god, that's what this is gonna look like, and like, oh my god, this is the church like that you guys picked out. They really created a whole world top to bottom, which was incredible.
So how are the teeth?
I didn't have to use teeth too much, but I do use them a little bit, and they were really interesting. The mold was like that gummy, disgusting thing, like when you make retainers. It was that, and then they just molded it to my canines, and there was a couple different options, sizes, like sharpness, you know, trying to decide what it would look like. And then ultimately, we went with like really sharp options in the end, and it really kind of helped me how to do the bite and how to like tilt it in a way that looks good on camera and everything. And then when we finally got got the final teeth. I guess it was a little too sharp, and my feeder was like, just a little less some pressure. And I was like, oh my god, am I like puncturing you and you're like bleeding out here? And she was like, no, it's fine, but just a little less. So I definitely learned how to bite properly. So for season 2, I will do it better. But yeah.
And for you?
You know what? I haven't got a chance to show off my teeth yet to play with it, but I will say that the teeth in the show look amazing. So people should be excited to see them.
So these vampires have special powers, and they have to show that on the screen. What are you guys doing when you're trying to make fires and everything else? How do you visualize it?
Oh, yeah. I mean, that's the great part about working on the show, too. Was I really wanted to have a little bit of agency over the magic, you know? I didn't want it to be, like, just a set motion, a set thing. So there are scenes where, like, everything that I envisioned out in the scene gets played out in the CGI. Like, I got to play with the fire, I get to throw it up in the air, I get to catch it, I get to do stuff like that. It was all just allowed by Julian Margaret to play around with. I had a little bit of experience, like you said, with Star Trek and Lock and Key, with working with things that weren't actually there, which can be a little bit difficult because you're expecting something to be there in front of you and then you have to pretend like it is when not right. But it's so much fun. Like, there's no kid who doesn't grow up and doesn't want to be like a superhero and shooting abilities. Yeah. There's a dream.
I think the elements
too,
like, we had a whole section of, I think, Jeff and then like really sat us down and showed us the different moves. So we created like moves for each element and all this stuff. I mean, Lissa doesn't really get to play too much with her element mental magic because she's not great at it. So I guess that's like part of it. But he did a great job at really owning like the fire and making us believe that he really is so well with fire, which is like a whole thing of Christians, and he's so amazing at fire. But yeah, it was a lot of fun, like the whole bowls thing in the first episode.
I'm not like a pyromaniac.